Connors is Martha's attorney, so how the hell are you going to use her?
Other than for the obvious.
I've been looking for a snitch named Lonnie O'Shea. I told her I'd ease up on Martha if he can shake Lonnie out of a tree.
Is this the same snitch you've been looking for 2 months, the one you think set your partner up?
Yeah, I'm hoping he can tie Martha to the shooting.
You got a truckload of things you could tie Martha to. I don't see him wrapped up in knots. Let's talk in my office.
Thanks for the backup, Frank.
Pleasure. Did I tell you I'd do what I could about your partner's death benefits?
I appreciate the effort.
Don't blow smoke up my ass, detective. You finding this Lonnie has got nothing to do with you busting Bertha and everything to do with you trying to clear your partner.
You connected the dots for me?
Well, I'm telling you, you could bust 10 saints out of heaven and make them swear that Beatty was as clean as St. Peter himself. It's not going to do any good. Now, IA thinks that you or your dead partner stole this money. And until one of you confesses, they're not going to release his death benefits. I put my neck out for you, Quinn. When nobody else would touch you, I took you in hand. You do what I brought you here to do. You bring me Jimmy Murtha and you do nothing else. Now, get out of here. I got a thing.
You gonna tell me what he said?
Yeah. Drop everything and find Lonnie.
I don't want you to worry about it,
Daniel. Yeah, why should I worry? I just killed a guy.
No, you didn't. Give me a gun.
Oh, my God.
Give me a gun. Look, don't worry. I already took care of the body. It ain't ever gonna be found. And if it is, well, then this is the gun that shot him. And this is the guy who did it.
Why are you showing me this? I don't want to know this.
Danny, you killed that scum to save my life. Now, that doesn't make you like me, or Mickey, or any of the rest. You're clean, Daniel. You didn't do it. And Dogface here, well, he ain't gonna say anything different. Now, you're never gonna hear me or anybody else ever mention this again. It didn't happen. Come on, killer. Let's go home.
Adult content. Parental discretion is advised.
You don't have to ask. I'm willing to work for a starting salary.
Mommy!
Then I'll work part-time. I'll work whatever hours you want. If you don't need me for a day, you don't pay me. Ah, oh, Jack. Just a minute, honey. Larry, I need a job.
I wanted some cereal.
I know. I quit. I was the one who did it. Larry, my husband was murdered. I don't think I was thinking about my career choices. I tried the agencies. Do you think I'd come begging back to you if I had any other options?
I wanted some cereal.
Oh, come on, Larry. I didn't mean it that way. Come on. For God's sake, Larry, pretend you're a human being for once in your life, huh? Aw, oh, it's okay. Come on. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, sweet. No. It's okay. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
How much?
Jimmy, there's structural damage. I can steal your equipment, I can steal your boots and stools, I can steal you all the liquor you want, but I can't steal a structure. It's too big a thing.
You trying to rob me? Huh? You trying to rob me? Danny, this guy's trying to rob me. Kill him. Just kidding. Now get out of here before I cut off your thieving hands.
Sweet spot. Your attorney.
Tell her I don't talk on the phone. Get her ass over here.
She says she's wearing white and she's not coming. I'm not telling him that.
Give me the phone. Are you looking to get whacked? Is that what you're looking to do? Because I got a guy here who's very handy with a gun.
Quinn wants Lonnie. What do you want to do?
What does this Lonnie guy to us?
You'd have to tell me that.
You know where you can get your hands on this guy? All right, get over here. We got things to discuss.
Get a place of business and we'll talk.
I'm a man without a country here. All right, let's go. Danny, watch the place. Anybody calls, take a message. Anybody comes in, shoot him.
Yeah, you're a barrel of laughs, Jimmy.
He's very funny, Jimmy.
Slow, Jimmy, but at least I'm here. Sorry about what happened to your place.
That's okay. We were thinking of moving anyway.
Oh, don't do this to me, Jimmy. Come on. I got everything into this joint. Please.
I mean, that's your problem. Business has become your life. That's not a good thing. I mean, look what it's doing to you. Mickey, doesn't he look bad?
Very bad.
Yeah. Sickly. You're looking worse by the minute.
Like he needs a vacation.
I just retire right now, Barry. I mean, you look so bad, you could die any second, right here in front of me.
I'm asking you, Jimmy. Come on, I mean, I know you for a long time. I mean, please, don't do this to me.
Remember, a year ago, I came in here with my friend, Dougie Tirano.
Yeah.
Remember we were sitting around, drinking, having a good time. You had that girl dancing on the bar.
I remember.
Remember we went into the bathroom? Remember Dougie coming out of the bathroom?
No.
No, me neither. Last time I saw Dougie, he was standing in front of the urinal. He's laughing, he's telling me something. Then I came out of the bathroom carrying a paper bag. You want to find out what was in that bag, Barry? Because I'll tell you.
Papers in the office, Jimmy. Tell me what you want me to sign.
He's looking healthy already.
Much, much healthier.
Mr. Mayor. Your police department seems to be unresponsive to my needs.
I made the call. A task force has been formed to take care of Mirtha. But if you insist on starting a war...
I had to send a message. The message was sent. There's no further need for violence. You have to look ahead now, though. look across the border. Every day, your citizens drive across that bridge taking their paychecks with them. That money ends up in a casino from which those citizens derive no benefit. Our city remains gutted and burned while theirs flourishes. A casino would be the best thing you could do for this community.
And the best thing for you.
Perhaps. But think of the jobs a casino would generate, the money. The money it would bring to a city that's on its knees. Like any good solution, everyone benefits. Even you.
Well, it's not going to happen. I will never be able to push this through city council.
Well, I would suggest approaching Councilman Ealing first. He owes you.
I don't want that.
Throw it away. I have no use for it.
Been to the old train station lately? If I was looking for someone who wanted to get lost, I would start looking there.
You want a beer?
You always open your door to strangers?
I didn't think we were.
Really? When did that change?
Nice to meet you, Lonnie.
Looking for a little extra help, Danny?
You don't have enough candles for me, Father. She just likes lighting them. Janie, say hi to Father Mac.
Do nuns have legs?
Yeah, many of them do, yeah. Many do.
I told you.
I was telling her that when I went to school, nuns wore habits. And I used to think, I never said it. I was sort of joking with her.
No, you what?
Janie, come say a prayer for your dad, okay? Because he's in a lot of trouble.
Okay.
How you doing, Danny?
Yeah, I'm okay. I'm just looking for a better job.
Better than working for Jimmy Murtha?
You're really tied in, aren't you, Father? Well, if you hear of anything, I'd really appreciate it.
Right. You sure that's the only thing weighing on you?
You know about my wife?
Mm-hmm. I think the two of you should come visit me.
Well, I don't know. I could try, but she's sort of living with someone.
Good. Bring him along. I'll put an end to that.
I'll bet you would. Wouldn't it be nice if it were that simple?
It is, Danny. That's the terrible truth. Everything is simple. Just hard to admit. There's only one way you can fail, and that's by giving up. No matter what happens, there's nobody who can make you do that.
Well, I'm never giving up on her, Father.
No, Danny, that's not what I'm worried about. I may be worrying that you're giving up on yourself.
I said true prayers for Mommy and true prayers for you.
Thanks, sweetie. I could use two.
Walk it down for me, Lonnie. You called my partner, Tim Beatty, gave him a tip.
I want a lawyer.
And I want a partner who can slap you around. But my old one's dead, and my new one I can't trust, so I gotta do it myself. I gotta be the good cop and the bad cop. It's very tiring. Right now, I'm the good cop. 30 seconds from now, that changes. You a junkie, Lonnie? Huh? You look like a junkie.
You called Beatty. I gave him a tip.
About what?
What did he tell you it was?
He said you knew someone who wanted to sell a truckload of guns for $10,000.
Then that's exactly what I said.
Look at that. 30 seconds is up.
Where'd we go?
Dragging your ass. Good luck, Lonnie. I'm gonna stay you like that for 72 hours. Sure you're not an addict, huh? You don't need a fix or nothing?
Can't see where I'm going. Let me walk.
We're taking the elevator line.
There is no elevator.
There's a shaft.
Hey!
Love the new place, Jimmy. Keep this up, they'll name a disease after you.
Yeah, well, just find out what I need to make it legal.
You mean like a deed?
You're worth every penny I pay you.
Now you need Barry's signature on a bill of sale.
That won't be a problem.
And you need to invalidate this.
You love messing with me, don't you? What is this?
It's an option to purchase this property. Barry signed it, and that company can exercise it any time during the next year.
Someone can buy my joint without even asking?
Res ipso loquitur.
Oh, I love it when you talk dirty.
Don't even think about it.
Just fix it, okay? My joint is for sale.
My rates just went up. Did I mention that? I'll turn this over to my paralegal. Maybe she can fit you in.
You know, you tell abroad once, you're not in the mood, they tear your skin off.
Pull it around, I'll meet you in the car.
Councilman Ealing, do you have a moment?
I'm on city time, Your Honor. I'm all yours. Everything okay, Chris? How's Marie doing?
Oh, fine, Carl. I just have a lot of things on my mind.
Well, let me take some of the weight. What can I do for you?
I need a favor.
It's done.
I have a bill I'd like to see you sponsor.
It's done.
Carl, I want to tell you straight. We could take some heat on this one.
Chris, listen to me. It's done. My aide is framing it right now.
I'm not sure I understand.
We have a mutual friend who said you needed a favor. You know I owe you. It's done. Just act surprised when you hear about it, and then offer your well-considered support.
It'll be fine.
Give my love to Marie. She's a good woman.
I'll do that.
So the guy says, why are you looking at me? What did I do? I'll catch you later.
Dana? Al? Did you come to confess a crime?
We hear you have Lonnie O'Shea. We checked the system. He isn't being held under that name.
Really? And why would IA be so interested in the $5 snitch?
He's going down in price. For the last 3 months, you've been telling us that this guy can clear your dead partner. Now you find him, you don't want to turn him over?
Well, if he tells me anything, you'll be the first to know, Dana.
If there's evidence that we should be considering and you're withholding
it... If you wanted to consider evidence, you would have. All you want to do is nail me, and you're willing to squeeze a dead cop to do it. But a dead cop is hard to squeeze, so you're squeezing his wife and kids.
We can't release Beatty's death benefits until we clear him. We can't clear him unless you cooperate.
Don't waste your breath, Dana.
You and your partner took $10,000 from the evidence locker. You say that you took it to the meat and your partner was ripped off. Give me one reason to believe you, and the widow gets her benefits. Or you could just save us all a lot of work and tell us where you hid it.
Does he ever talk?
We want you, snitch. There are just so many precincts and so many holding cells. We're gonna find them.
Tell me about the guns, Lonnie.
Told you already.
Yeah, and I've only kept you for 24 hours.
Man, don't do this to me. I gotta get out. I'm not feeling well. I gotta get to a doctor.
The truth is, Lonnie, I keep changing your name on the form. I keep moving you around. I can hold you as long as I want. So what do you say? You want to tell me now or in a few weeks?
You were Tim's partner, right?
I was his partner.
You know what your partner was up to, man? You know what he was asking me about?
I want to hear from you.
You don't know, do you? You have no idea. Damn. You're in it now, aren't you? It were no guns. This wasn't about guns. Your partner made that up.
My partner made it up.
He was looking for information about a group called the Tamarack Boys. This means nothing to you. That either means he didn't trust you, or he was trying to protect you. It's a group of cops who went to some very heavy things. Arson, drugs, kidnapping, extortion, murder. Very dirty, very inside, very well protected.
So why are they called the Tamarack Boys?
I don't know. Maybe because Murder, Inc. was already taken.
And how do you know all this?
Did you check my Jackie?
I got it memorized, Lonnie.
So you know I used to be a cop. What? My 10 card conveniently missing, was it? Isn't that amazing? Yeah, that was me. Blue serge, brass buttons. When I wasn't busting scum like me, I was running errands. Take a bag here, pick up a bag there. Sometimes I couldn't help but look inside those bags. I should have never looked, man. I started sampling the contents. I lost everything. Your partner found me. Started asking me some questions. He was a good guy, your partner. You know what he did for me once?
I don't care what he did for you. I want to know what you did to him.
They found out I was talking to him.
Who?
Who? Cops. Big cops, little cops. Cops. That's who. They found out I was talking to your partner, and they pulled me in on a phony drug bust.
Mm.
Their faces kept changing every time I saw them. They were like roaches,
all right,
man,
all right,
everywhere.
So they pulled you in.
They told me I had a choice. Go away for 10 to 12, or set up a meet with your partner. I was to tell him I had proof. Something that would put them all away. And I needed $10,000 for it.
So what the hell was Tim doing investigating cops, huh? How come he didn't go to IA?
For all we know, he did, man. IA are cops. Cops are cops. I haven't found a clean one in this town yet, have you?
All right. So you called Tim to set up the meet. He told me he couldn't get the money from our lieutenant. Now I know why. He asked me to get it from the evidence locker. So I got him the money. I give it to him. He gives it to you.
Not to me, man. I didn't go in the meet. I was never there.
Someone was in the car, Lonnie. Somebody he trusted. Otherwise, he doesn't get in.
All they wanted me to do was make a phone call, and I did. Then I disappeared. When you found me, I thought you were one of them come to kill me. I've been hiding ever since. I'm sorry about what happened to your partner. I liked him.
I'm gonna type this up. You're gonna have to sign it.
Okay. Quinn?
I'd like to trust you, Lonnie. But you and I both know I take off those cuffs, you're gonna run.
Not always good. No one thinks like that about yourself, is he?
Where the hell have you been?
Well, what's up?
I have a friend in internal affairs who just called to raid your partner's house.
They turned it over top to bottom twice.
And they got a wrecking crew in there. They're pulling up the floorboards. I thought you'd want to know.
Till I come get him.
You see, that's not good enough doings.
You want me to tell you what Ely is up to? Or are you going to tell me?
Councilperson Weiler. As usual, you take my very breath away.
Ely is drafting a bill to legalize gambling.
Really? Well, they've come at us with that one before.
Ely wouldn't try something like this unless he had plenty of high cover. And you're the only one that flies that high.
Patricia. I haven't even read the bill. You know my position on gambling. If there isn't a substantive benefit to the city...
Substantive benefit? You already know how you're going to sell this, don't you?
Patricia.
You want to do this to me in bed, Christian? I will always enjoy it. But don't try it here, or I will cross my legs and snap your neck.
Ellie?
I was dreaming, Danny.
It's the middle of the day. You're daydreaming.
Well, I was dreaming about us, you know? Before you went to prison. You and me and Janie. in that yellow high chair. I was dreaming I was happy.
Well, we're gonna be happy again.
I heard about Frankie Balshack. I was worried about you.
I'm okay.
Yeah, so you weren't there?
No, I wasn't there.
You didn't kill no one?
No. I didn't kill nobody.
Lying's starting to come easier to you, Denny. Starting to come easier to you, Denny. You know who's easy to lie to? Janie. I know because I do it all the time. She believes you. And that's what hurts, don't it? Having someone believe you.
Internal Affairs got here 5 minutes after you left. Detective Larkin.
Chet Ball's an Iron Man. I couldn't do nothing.
Your snitch? We released him.
Released? You stupid bitch.
I told you we'd find him. You should have worked with us.
Work with you? I've seen the way you work. Wait, you plant the money under the floorboards before you ripped them up, or was it after?
You don't want to be making charges like that.
I mean, under the floorboards? For God's sakes, which one of you geniuses thought that up? And then what do? You give Lonnie a one-way ticket out of town?
His statement. You want to read it or not? According to Lonnie, your partner approached him about buying some guns.
Oh, this is ridiculous.
Lonnie said he knew someone who would sell them for $1,000. Apparently, your partner took $1,000 to the meet and he kept $9,000 for himself.
And you believe this?
We found $9,000 under his floorboards. I'd call that corroboration.
This is a fairy tale. Lonnie told you what you wanted to hear.
Really? Well, he did do one thing for you, pal. He told Lonnie that you didn't know anything about it. All right? This clears you. Do you get it? You're clear.
Who got to him?
What are you talking about?
He changed his statement.
Look, if you have a
that means that somebody got to him. Who got to him?
No one!
So that's it. You're gonna bury a good cop on the word of a dirty one. You are taking the word of a junkie.
Yeah. All we have is his word. $9,000 under your partner's floor and the name of the shooter. Lonnie gave us the name of the shooter, the guy who was selling the guns, the guy who killed your partner. George Keady. 3 times convicted felon, 2 of those convictions for attempted murder. That's the guy that killed your partner. About a week after the shooting, the feds picked him up on an unrelated weapons charge. We did a search. We found him in the system.
I'm waiting for it.
Keady was being held pending indictment. There was an incident. He was stabbed in the heart.
That's neat, isn't it? Lonnie gave you the name of a dead man.
What do you think? Do you think that everyone is conspiring against you and your partner? Is that what you think?
Who tipped you off about the house?
It was an anonymous call. Come on, you know that's how we do most of our business. Nobody wants to be known for turning in a cop.
So what about Tim's death benefits?
You have got to be kidding.
He's a dirty cop. We caught him red-handed. The wife is lucky we don't lock her up as being a conspirator. The money was in her house. She could have just been waiting to spend it. Get out of my office. Go back to work. Just feel lucky that you still have a badge, because it could have gone the other way. And between us, I was praying that it would.
Unless you've come to confess, I got nothing to say to you.
And then it's your lucky day. You get two for one. Lonnie was my snitch. He's lying to save my ass. I took the money. I set up the deal.
You took the money. I don't like being played, detective.
Then you're in the wrong city.
You want to save your partner, do it on someone else's time.
Save him? I took the $10,000 from the evidence locker and I gave Tim one. I hadn't planned on him getting killed, but when he did, when it went bad, I went to his house and I hid the money. I figured he was dead, right? What else could happen to him?
Get a stenographer.
What the hell was that all about?
I confessed.
You confessed?
I've been arraigned and released on my own recognizance.
God in heaven, you are a piece of work. Did you do it?
Doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter? You just blew my chance to get Mirtha because you thought today was a good day to self-immolate, but that doesn't matter! Get the hell out of my sight.
He's on.
Then get out! He just blew himself up. Quinn, he blew himself up, confessed to the money thing. I don't know, I know if he did it. In my gut, I think no. 3 or 4 months. I'm not making this up. That's how long it'll take me to get someone else next to Mirtha. I can't fix this one. It's gonna have to come from on high. Yeah.
Will is about as subtle as your taste in women.
Well, I tasted you first.
Something to remember in your infirmity. I tracked down the corporation that owns the option on your bar. Registered in the Dutch Antilles.
That's ridiculous. What would the Dutch want with my bar?
Ah, that is the question of the hour, isn't it? The answer is hidden within the original articles of incorporation. The controlling shareholder is one Michael Fivers Dugan.
Dugan owns my bar? Dugan owns my bar?
At least the option to buy it.
What the hell does he want with my dump?
Ask a Dutchman. I'm done for the day.
It's a cop bar. Are you sure they'll let you drink in here?
Charges were dropped. Your suspension stuck for all of 2 hours. I don't know what you did. I don't know who you have in your pocket. I don't even want to know. But when they don't need you anymore, I'll be there.
Forget it. I'm not taking it back. You go back to whoever sent you and you tell them I'm not taking the deal.
What?
Tim's benefits. His wife gets his full benefits, or they get this back in the mail tomorrow morning.
Why should they care?
They shouldn't.
I talked to Internal Affairs. They told me you confessed. What did you think? He's dead, so it doesn't matter if he looks dirty? God, Cam, how could you do it? Or am I supposed to think that you didn't? Because I know who you are. That you'd lie to protect him. Me. I can't follow all the lies, Cam. I don't know who you are. Did I ever? Did he?
Me, Father, for I've sinned.
He was looking for information on a group called the Tamarack Boys.